We can quickly review marginal cost, concept of marginal cost first. So marginal cost is denoted as MC, and marginal cost is defined as an additional cost of producing one additional unit of a product. So marginal cost is calculated as change in total cost divided by change in quantity produced. Numerically, we can find marginal cost through this table. Let's say we are producing quantity, certain quantity of good and service, and this is the total cost, and we can add one more column, that is marginal cost. For example, initially if a firm was producing 100 units and its total cost was $1,000, now it decided to produce one additional unit and its total cost increased to $1,200. So marginal cost in this situation will be change in total cost over change in quantities. Change in quantity is equal to 1, and change in total cost is from 1,000 to 1,200. So change in total cost is equal to 200. So 200 divided by 1 is equal to 200. Marginal cost is calculated this way. And इसका हमने ये भी देखा था कि अगर आपको एक मैथमेटिकल इक्वेशन दी हो, टोटल कॉस्ट इज लेट्स से 50 प्लस 5 क्यू स्क्वायर लेट्स से, सो वी कैन फाइंड मार्जिनल कॉस्ट फ्रॉम दिस इक्वेशन एज वेल. सो मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज द फर्स्ट डेरिवेटिव ऑफ टोटल कॉस्ट. सो इसको जब हम डेरिवेटिव लेते हैं तो इन व्हाइल टेकिंग डेरिवेटिव ऑफ एनी इक्वेशन द कॉन्स्टेंट इज cancel and it becomes zero, and we will take derivative of 5q square. So the method for taking derivative is 5. We will bring power down and it will multiply to q, so multiply by 5, and now 2 minus 1. This is basic principle of taking derivative. We bring power down and we deduct 1 from the power. So 5 2s are 10. 10q, 2 minus 1 is 1. When there is power 1, we need not to write it. So 10q will be the marginal cost. On x, we have quantity produced, and on y, we have cost. Marginal cost looks like this. All costs are almost U-shaped. We already explained average cost, which is like this. This is average variable cost. Relations between these costs can be clearly seen through the diagram. This is average cost. This is average variable cost. And next we will draw marginal cost, and marginal cost is lowest than these costs initially. Then it intersects from minimum point of average variable cost. Then it intersects from minimum point of average cost, and it would be greater than average cost and average variable cost later on. If we consider this point, at point A, we are producing total output equal to Q, and this is the point where average variable cost is minimum and marginal cost is equal to average variable cost. Mean examiner अगर आपको टेस्ट करता है कि find out the point where average variable cost is minimum, तो आपको बताना होगा कि द पॉइंट वेयर मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज इक्वल टू एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, दैट पॉइंट वुड बी द मिनिमम पॉइंट ऑफ एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. लेकिन अगर आउटपुट क्यू पे हम इसी लाइन को थोड़ा एक्सटेंड करें, मैं इसी सेम परपेंडिकुलर को एक्सटेंड करता हूँ. इफ वी एक्सटेंड द सेम परपेंडिकुलर ऑफ आउटपुट क्यू, देन वी कैन सी दैट एवरेज कॉस्ट इज स्टिल फॉलिंग. एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट इज मिनिमम, मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इज इक्वल टू एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. और क्या हमें यहाँ पे पता चला? एवरेज कॉस्ट इज ग्रेटर देन एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट, एवरेज कॉस्ट इज स्टिल ग्रेटर देन मार्जिनल कॉस्ट, एंड एवरेज कॉस्ट इज स्टिल फॉलिंग. अब नेक्स्ट हम पॉइंट देखते हैं. नेक्स्ट पॉइंट हमारे पास ये कि व्हेन मार्जिनल कॉस्ट इंटरसेक्ट्स एवरेज एवरेज कॉस्ट एट पॉइंट, लेट्स से दिस इज पॉइंट बी. एट पॉइंट बी द आउटपुट इज क्यू वन. ओके, नाउ एट आउटपुट क्यू वन एवरेज कॉस्ट इज इक्वल टू मार्जिनल कॉस्ट, एंड एवरेज कॉस्ट इज मिनिमम, बिकॉज एट पॉइंट बी दिस इज द मिनिमम पॉइंट ऑफ एवरेज एवरेज कॉस्ट, एंड एवरेज कॉस्ट इज स्टिल ग्रेटर देन एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट. एंड अनदर थिंग इज Average variable cost is rising. Average variable cost is rising. आप देख सकते हैं क्यू आउटपुट क्यू पे अगर आप देखें तो एवरेज वेरिएबल कॉस्ट हैज स्टार्टेड राइजिंग. वाई एवरेज कॉस्ट कर्व इज यू शेप्ड. अच्छा पीछे हम ड्रॉ करते हैं लेकिन हमने ये नहीं देखा कि एवरेज कॉस्ट की यू शेप क्यों बनती है, लाइक वाई इट लुक्स लाइक दिस इन शॉर्ट. सो देयर आर थ्री रीजंस बिहाइंड दिस. द वन इज इंक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल, कॉन्स्टेंट रिटर्न्स टू स्केल, डिमिनिशिंग और डिक्रीजिंग रिटर्न्स टू स्केल. In other words, we can say that if we double our input, our output would be more than double. If we increase our input by 10%, output will increase more than 10%. If we increase input by 50%, output will rise more than 50%. So it will lead to lower the average cost of production. Let's say we have two periods, year one and year two. In year one, we had input. Input is basically cost and we had output. Output is denoted as Q. Add another column, that is average cost. And average cost is calculated as total cost divided by quantity. Input of $100 and we can produce 10 units of a product. Let's say if we spend $100, we can produce, let's say, 10 chairs. And now we decided to double our input, like from 100 to 200. Now we are spending double amount and our output increases more than double. Like if we double the output, it would be 20. But if we increase it more than double, then it will be 25 or anything above 20. Average cost is the total cost divided by quantity. In year one, total cost is $100 and output is 10. So 100 over 10 will give us 10 average cost. And now we will divide 200 by 25. So 200 divided by 25 will give us 8. So initially average cost falls. The graph for increasing returns would look like this. So average cost is initially falling. Then in case of constant returns to scale, if we double our input, output will be exactly double. Average cost will remain the same. Again, we can draw a table for constant returns to scale and we have number of years, like we have year one and two and we have input. Input is basically cost and this is output, which is quantity, and this is average cost. So input was initially 100 and output was 10. So average cost was 10. Now we decided to double our input, but our output increased by exactly double. So from 10, it would become 20. So 200 over 20 will again give us average cost equal to $10. Ab isme ye hai ki humne input ko double kiya, output bhi exactly double ho gaya. Like dono cheeze same proportion se chunki rise kar rahi hain, isliye average cost pe koi farak nahi pada. So the second segment of average cost will look like this. So average cost is constant or same. In the last situation, that is decreasing returns to scale, or we also call it diminishing returns to scale. In diminishing returns to scale, if we double our input, output will increase by less than double. In hum number of years le rahe hain, 1 and 2, and this is input. Initially input was 100 and output was 10, so average cost would be 10. If we double our input, like we increase input from 100 to 200, but output increases by less than double, let's say it's 13.3. so isme hame kya nazar aaya ki average cost, when we increased input, like our average cost is increasing. So average cost will look like this. And finally, if we sum up all these segments, like increasing returns, constant returns and decreasing returns, then we will get average cost, which will look like a U-shape. Draw initially the falling segment, then constant segment, then rising segment, and then average cost will look like this. So this part is RIS, increasing returns to scale. This is CRS, constant returns to scale. And this is DRS, decreasing returns to scale. The reason behind average cost being U-shaped in the shortened period of time. And an average cost is the sum of shortened average cost curves, and it is also U-shaped. And in long run is a period of time in which all factors of production are variable. Like we can purchase new land, we can purchase new machinery, new technology, that kind of period would be longer in period of time, and we don't consider number of years in economics. We just consider the four factors of production to determine whether it is short run or long run. In long run, average cost curve is also U-shaped like short run average cost curves, and long run average cost curve is the sum of, or it is the combination of short run average cost curves. In this graph, we have quantity on X and long run average cost on Y axis. We have short run average cost 1, short run average cost 2, short run average cost 3, and short run average cost 4. If we sum up these costs, and we can find different tangency points, and we can join these points by another line, and this cost would be long run average cost. The blue line is long run average cost, which is basically the sum of short run average cost curves. Again, long run average cost curve is also U-shaped, and I'm drawing another graph. So long run average cost curve is a bit greater than short run average cost, but it is again U-shaped, and the reasons for being U-shaped in long run include, number one is called economies of scale, and it is minimum at minimum efficient scale, and it increases due to diseconomies of scale.